You ready for me?
Yes.
Let's call the Monday, June 28th, regular council meeting. Order and ask for a roll call, please.
Danny Long.
Here.
Kevin Plain.
Here.
Adam Moorhead.
Here.
Jackie Thomas.
Here.
John Wargo.
Here.
Catherine Whitman.
Here.
Joe Baker.
Here. We have a quorum established, and ask everyone in the audience, please, if they have a hat on, remove it. Place your hand over your heart, and AJ is going to play the Pledge of Allegiance for us.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, I thank you for that, everyone. This evening, as you can see, we have the Carbon Valley Parks and Recreation District in a presentation, and I believe we have our board president here, which is Cody Childress. And looks like Dean's on from the Rec District, and also Bill Haidt, they're here from the district. So I think, is it, Cody, are you doing the presentation, or are we?
I'm letting Dean do it.
Oh, you're passing the buck. All right, Dino, you're up grabs, sir. And so if you wouldn't mind, introduce yourself. We do have some new council members. Tell us who you are, and then we'll just let you roll right into your presentation.
Great. Thanks, Mayor. Hello, everyone. Dean Romo, Executive Director, Carbon Valley Parks and Recreation District. Thanks for having us tonight. If you don't know, we've been working for about the last, well, over 2 years now. It started with a feasibility study in 2019 of just trying to understand our next growth, our best place in the community, and what that all looks like. And really talking to our community, our district, which is the Dacono, Firestone, Frederick, and some of the surrounding areas of, you know, what support is there and what ideas exist for that growth opportunity. I have a PowerPoint presentation that I'd love to go through and just kind of walk you through where we're at and where we're going, if you would like to go that route.
Say it one more time, Dean. You're on my end, you gurgled a little bit. You've got a presentation for us?
I do. If you could give me, 15 minutes to get through it, and then we'd love to answer any questions if that would work.
Yeah, if you can give us a little more concise, only because we have an executive session that's going to bring us into about 9:30, 10 o'clock tonight. And so if you can, not to be disrespectful to you, but you'll probably lose all of our attention in about 8 minutes just because we're all focused on this agenda right now. There's a very important piece that's on the bottom of that agenda that we're definitely,
okay.
It's got everyone's hearts racing a little bit right now. So we want to take care of that. And I know that's kind of the focus. And I'm not sure if you'll have, I know you won't have my attention. I'll just be right up front with you as far as I know where you guys are at. But if you get about 7 or 8 minutes into it, I'm going to be looking at, I'm going to be scrolling down that agenda on you.
Okay. If I could, can I share my screen, or yeah. AJ Val, do you have what I shared earlier?
Dean, you should be able to share your screen.
Okay. Share screen. Okay. I will move through this quickly, and I'll keep an eye on the time. Do you see it there?
There you go.
Okay. Okay, so the district is looking at what our expansion plans could possibly look like, and go into the, hopefully to the voters in November to help support these plans. Our board of directors will make that final decision in August to get certified with the county for a November election. So I'm going to kind of go through some of these. So again, started in 2019 with Barker Rinker CCAT, a very well-known up and down the Front Range consulting architectural firm, with the hopes of launching a feasibility study. with that, some of the main outcomes, and I know we've spoke to this before, was an outdoor aquatics, a second recreation center, increased senior activity spaces, and then some outdoor court space. What we ended up doing was, you know, putting it on hold like much of the world last year with COVID, and in February tried to get a heat check on the community. Okay, this is what we heard in 2019. Now, what are we hearing in 2021? And we had very high attendance in a short amount of time, just in a community outreach survey that still supported those things. You know, we wanted to do, okay, we had this pandemic happening. It's still actually kind of happening. Do you still support these things? And not only do you support them, will you use them? And, you know, nothing's free, right? Would you also support a small tax increase? Through this whole process, we're looking to do, if people didn't know, in 2019, we paid off the obligation bond that was paying for the build of the current recreation center in Frederick. So that was paid off, and everyone's tax contributions to the district went down for that, just over 3.7 mils. So what we're asking and proposing would be bring it back up 3.7, and here's how we can expand and what we can bring. So essentially what it's looking to be, we're looking to propose is a second recreation center with an outdoor water park attached to it. Originally started with just an outdoor pool, and then we realized that that wasn't really what people were asking and wanting. They wanted more and bigger, more of a draw, something that you can come and spend all day at. So it's morphed into an outdoor water park with additional courts next to it. Working very, very closely with the town of Firestone to put this near, if not right next to the library in Central Park. It's not up in Barefoot Lakes. It would be right in the middle next to the library and police station in Firestone. And let me say this. I know I don't have much time, but it's so important that I say it a couple times. It would be a second recreation center. That would not mean the recreation center in Frederick that is the closest to Dacono would be closing by any means. We're continuing to invest in that one along the way. I just want to show you some of the images. It would be a similar size to the current one, but the current one is very busy. And we're seeing that post-COVID recovery time. It's just very, very busy. Our programs are busy. The weight rooms are busy. The gyms are busy. The pool is busy. What the concept would be, would build this second one, not only for the growing population, but also to take some relief off that current one that's more towards the southern part of the district. Our consultants have said it great, and I use it over and over. That current rec center was built 20 years ago for a community of 10,000 people. As everyone's probably well aware, the district now is middle 30s, about 36,000 people encumber our Parks and Rec district. So I'm just going to show you some images here. Again, the water park with multiple age attractions, from kiddie pool to lap swimmers to, you know, people with zero depth entry to slide seekers, and just cabanas of folks that want to hang out. Different images. As I go through, I'm not going to spend too much of time just talking about them. A wave ball, just some fun features. A wave ball is not, there's not one like it in Colorado. So trying to do some unique features as well, with, of course, lots of deck space and rental space. And again, you can come and spend your whole day here. To put it in perspective of just size, this is a graphic I like of what we're looking to do. We're looking to do fairly large here. If you're familiar with the Lafayette Water Park or the Brighton Water Park, it's about double the size of the two of those. So really looking to be an attraction. A piece of this is expanding the senior center as well. So this is a zoomed in, hopefully new look at the senior center, where the senior, where it says senior fitness, it's just to show the current senior center. And then it would be expanding out into the current outdoor area and making that all enclosed as well. And then having more of a kind of senior coffee hallway of just tables and chairs and the coffee. What we really have are two types of seniors. We have our passive and our active seniors. The passive want to come and play cards and do puzzles and drink coffee and socialize. We've seen it more than ever in the lack of being able to get together and socialize with COVID, of having their own space to do so. But we also have very active seniors that want to take fitness classes and stability classes and have more offerings of mobility and things like that. So having those separate spaces without having to fully close for one or the other is a big desire and need we're hearing from our senior population as well, that we would like to accomplish in this one ballot initiative of increasing what we already have. So what we're looking to do is right around about $30 million. That would be to build and to operate. It'd be about a 2-year, finalized design and complete the construction, probably not as long with the senior component. And on an average house in the district, if you're escrowing your taxes, it's about $10 or less a month is what it comes to. I'll show you that here. So the messy part of taking a property value and figuring out what that actually means in a mill, we've tried to come up with some cheat sheets to be sharing with the community. So if you can see, if your property is worth, I'm just going right in the middle, $500,000, your annual increase would be about $96.53, which is about $9 a month. It would be the direct impact on someone's taxes. Again, contributions to the district have gone down over the last 2 years with that obligation bond payoff. Might not mean everyone's taxes have gone down, but just to show what the minimal expense to get all these things that we're talking about would be. On our website, we have a calculator where you can go in and put your market value, and it does all the math for you. It breaks down your assessed value, annual cost of what 2.7 mils actually looks like. Just trying to get tools out there, trying to spread the word and being very transparent in the process. We're committing to as many events as we can throughout the community. Again, we just want people to know what's happening. We want them to know, if this ends up on a ballot in November, exactly what it is. Doesn't mean everyone's going to love it. Doesn't mean everyone's going to have a yes vote next to it. But just the more we can let people know what's going on, the more successful we think as a district we'll be doing, just our due diligence through the process. You can help, one, by asking questions, getting involved. We have, our website is just full of the plans and proposals and FAQs that we're hearing, common questions from people. And again, just really trying to share and get out in front of things. And not have misleading information out there. Our board of directors are going to decide in August. Bill and Cody, who represent Dacono, they are fantastic. So I know they know about as much of this as I do, and would be more than happy to share more information and be a part of other things. But just really getting citizens to know what's going on. Whew. That was the quickest I've talked about this. Are there any questions of any of what I just shared?
Yeah. So is it near the High Plains Library, near Colorado Boulevard and I think Sable Avenue? Is that right?
That's correct. That's the piece of property that we're working very closely with Firestone on right now.
Okay. Okay. Thanks.
Yep.
Other questions, council?
I'm sorry. I only had one question. This is Kathy Whitman. On the senior center, the gymnasium that's there, the gymnastics, is that going to remain where it's at, along with the senior center being extended south?
Yes, it is. They coexist fairly well, just with the timings of the two, major operations that happen, where the senior center currently closes at 4. So yes, it would just be expanding of that building.
So their meals, were at the rec center for a while. Are they going to be back down at the senior center then?
You know, right now that's still a drive-through service because that is ran through Weld County. And the hope would be get it all in one building, one facility, because we also hear that from the seniors. I go to lunch at the rec center and I always say I'm going to stop over and have a cup of coffee and socialize, but then I just drive by. So a part of this definitely is trying to have it all in one location.
Yeah, so we can get them back like they were before. Cool. Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah, so if this ends up on the ballot in November, just a bit of advice is to maybe throw something in there for the residents of Dacono that's a bit closer to Dacono, if there's something that you can find that would benefit Dacono, because this is, you know, way out there from us, right? And Dacono would be affected by the tax increase as well.
So how does that happen, Kevin? How do you throw something in there on the ballot for Dacono?
I don't know, something for, you know, the BMX track maybe, or something around that area, Clem DeFore Park somewhere.
But we're funding the deep BMX track.
We could use some help maybe, Mayor. I'm just saying, if they want something to pass on the ballot, it might be good to have something for Dacono in there.
I get it. Go ahead, Danny.
Yeah, you know, you're moving this 5 miles away from Dacono, you know, and you expect us to vote on it. We've given up our BMX track already. Our kids can't go use that. You know, you should do something down south here instead of going further north. I mean, you don't have my support on this. So thanks for listening.
Oh, nope. And I thank you for your time. Joe, I'll jump in here real quick. This is Cody Childers, the president of the CVPRD. With what limited resources all municipalities have, we did the best we could with what we have available. And as obscure as Joe knows I can be, I've thrown it out there a couple times to help with even just the idea of some mutually advantageous economic development marketing for Dacono businesses as well. IMI Blitz, restaurants as well. For the future, when this opens, or if it opens, if we put on a ballot, to help out Dacono as much as possible. With that said, multiple conversations have been had, possibilities have been examined, and this is just the best that we have right now. If the city council has any other options at all, I welcome to hear them if possible.
I have a suggestion or a thought. This is Jackie Thomas. Joe, is it okay if I go ahead?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Get in there, Jackie. Absolutely. Okay.
Just a thought that maybe at the current facility that you offer Dacono residents a discount. I don't know what that looks like, but something that would be enticing for Dacono residents that are helping to foot this bill. That would be helped, you know, if it passes. But maybe something like that would be enticing to a family in Dacono, or even a couple or individuals in Dacono.
I think it's important that, you know, our desire as the Parks and Rec District, the community is going to continue to keep growing. All three towns in the city, right? This is just our next step. Doesn't mean the following step isn't, you know, south of 52 either, type of a deal. This is just our best next step that we were, you know, 15 acres of land were available for us to produce this type of a product as well. So but I'm definitely echo everyone's, Cody, and I think Bill raised his hand here too, of, you know, just ideas and suggestions are always welcome.
I just wanted to this is Bill Haight. I'm on the Parks and Rec board from Dacono, representing Dacono, and one of the advantages I see, which we haven't talked about, but as a new facility becomes available further north, our current facility in Frederick opens up. It's pretty crowded in there now as people want to use the the rec center and the pool that we currently have. We hope that the new facility will open up some space in the present facility and make it a more enjoyable experience for those who are still using the rec center in Frederick. There could be an advantage that way. I agree with Cody. There's some real economic development things to look forward to as something like this starts to bring in more business to the whole Carbon Valley. I think, you know, Dacono can benefit from that as well. Just a couple of points. Thank you.
Cool. Danny, do you have another question or just a hand up? You're on mute, buddy.
Yeah, you know, we have nothing here in Dacono for our kids. You know, so they go try to get in trouble some other way. You know, like, you know, I'm just saying, we need something for our kids to do. It's not safe for them to go across the highway. You know, to go over through the rec center and do stuff over there. We need stuff here in Dacono.
Thanks, Dan.
Just saying, Joe.
Oh, you're fine. Got a lot of emotions here. So I got a couple of questions just by way of background. The seniors are meeting how many times a week at the gymnastics place? Do we know that number?
Well, I mean,
every day?
Every day seniors are meeting.
And they're open. And when are we feeding them?
Twice a week, Weld County is in there with their food service on Tuesdays and Thursdays.
So Tuesdays and Thursdays they're getting a meal, and then the rest of the time they're just coming for activity in the lounge at the gymnasium, or at the lounge in the miniature rec center, and then the gymnasium's used for a lunch hall when they feed them, correct?
No, not anymore. The lunch hall, the gymnasium is not, the lunch was happening over at the rec center, okay. In the multi-purpose room. And that's a piece of the expansion. And right now, senior activities happen over at the recreation center and also at the studio over by Dairy Queen as well. So again, spread out pretty far. A big desire of mine is to have that one central location.
Okay. Danny, do you have another question or just a hand up? You're on mute, buddy. You're on mute. You're on mute. You're still on mute, brother.
I'm just trying to figure out how to shut this hand wave thing.
Nah, you're fine. Then I'll just keep calling you out for the rest of the night, buddy. Relax. You're good. You're good.
You know, Mayor, I had a very quick question, if you don't mind.
No.
I don't want to dogpile. I think I share in some of the concerns of the other council members. So I feel like everybody here has a kind of a sense of where we're coming from. But I was going to ask Dean or even Cody, of the 3.7 mils or roughly $10 a month that, you know, Dacono residents would pay, how much of that 3.7 is allocated for this new facility, and how much that would be allocated to other projects outside of that facility?
Nope. Great question. It's 2.7 and about two of them is for the build and process and how we're proposing it will be written. Excess of what that covers will go towards improvements of the current facilities and additional improvements. And then, you know, with everything that, believe it or not, or, you know, if you know, building these things is the cheapest thing. It's operating them for the next 40 years, that is always the most expensive piece. So being a special district like we are funded two ways, through property taxes and user fees. So right now the proposal would be about 0.7 of that to go towards operations and two towards building and improvements of that building and our current ones.
So nothing for expansion or any new projects out of that money. It's either the new facility or improvements on the existing facilities at this point in time.
That would be correct for those, yes.
Okay, thank you.
Yep.
Other questions, council? So I guess since it's on the table really quick. And in fairness to Dean, Cody, and Bill, you guys don't have the history because you're kind of new to the whole system. So just by way of background for the council to understand that where I get passionate or I get a little too emotional about certain things. One of the things is the seniors. So the senior center used to be in Dacono when I first moved here. They had their own senior center all by themselves. And then the mayor of Frederick did a very good job. Great guy, by the way, Eric Doring. And the rec district did a good job of getting everyone, not just Dacono, but everyone to include. Dacono had to vote into the district. And then the premise or what I get feedback from the seniors were that when they moved to Frederick, they were going to move and get their own rec center. That's mostly taken place, but there's a lot of things that I get feedback from the seniors. And that's in my mind, in my passion, in my service with the city and being in my position, I feel that we have a responsibility to the seniors because they're the building blocks of the reason why that we are here. And we owe them something. If there's anyone that's entitled in the world, in my personal opinion and professional opinion, it's the seniors because they've paved the way for us. And so I've been to the senior center. I think everybody else has been to the senior center, has been here for a while. And a lot of the feedback that I get back from them is they feel like they're getting pushed out or pushed back, or they don't get to share this or they don't get to share that. And I'm talking pre-COVID, so COVID doesn't count. And I like the new rec center. Bill Hade is absolutely right. That new rec center is going to facilitate my age and younger and whoever age is that's not doing that to be able to go out, go to the pool, go to splash parks and so on and so forth. And kids, it can be driven wherever they feel like it. But these seniors, some of them can't drive. Some of them can't get around. Some of them, they're only eating twice a week that I've talked to at that senior center. When they're eating on Tuesdays and Thursdays, they're only eating there, or the Weld County Food Bank is feeding them, or the church over here is giving them food. And then people are bringing them food or bringing them meals. And there's no kitchen in this senior center. And when I see that the words new rec center, then right next to that, I see expanded senior space, which means we're giving them an extra room. It's disheartening. I can say that IMI and Blitz, you know, they're their own business. They're going to do just fine in Dacono. It's great to kind of promote that sports center and that recreation center. The kids, as far as I'm concerned, they will have a way to get to those parks. I'd love to have a rec center or a pool in Dacono. I don't see the rec center getting there yet because I think the growth is going to be faster on the north end than it is going to be on the south end. Eventually we'll book in, but my passion lies with the seniors. My passion lies with every time when I talk to the seniors, I'll just put it this way in my rant, is that they feel like they were sold a bill of goods and they didn't get what they wanted. They were promised a new building or a building for their own use. And now it's a shared, which is fine. But most of the people that I talk to that go to the seniors pre-COVID felt like that they were either in somebody else's living room, interrupting their flow while they were there. And a lot of the feedback, especially the Dacono and some of the Frederick folks, felt like that they were being either pushed out or shut, you know, hey, we got to go. Gymnastics are taking place. Let's go, let's go, let's go. So I'm not asking you, Dean, or Bill or Cody to change that, but something has to change when you're asking for $30 million. I get the participation part. None of us like taxes. Personally, I don't like taxes, but there's a lot of things that the city wants to work with on the rec center. But as you can hear the passion from like Danny or even Kathy, even Kevin, and asking for, and Jackie saying, give me a discount or do something. Like, how do we incentivize the Dacono residents? I think it's easy to sell the Dacono residents on $10 a month for a guy my age. Now go talk to a 75-year-old Dacono resident that's been here for 35 years, and you're going to get, there's Danny with his hands up, you're going to get a lot more pushback because they're the ones that feel like they've been kind of shoved out. I think I can sell ice cubes to Eskimos, and so therefore I feel like I can sell anybody anything. So the 10 bucks isn't the point. It's what am I getting for my $10? And I don't know how to emulate that to you guys or push that onto you guys. And like I said, it's not your fault, Dean, nor Cody, nor Bill, because you don't have the history. When I moved here, I used to go to the senior center because I'd use it for the Halloween candy give out that night or something like that. So when I first got here, there was an actual building and everything, and I thought that was cool. And then when it transpired into that, I remember going to the senior center and I just got this really bad vibe. Now, I don't know if you're getting the same vibe, that people are a little bit more transparent with me only because I've got a badge on, right? So I get the complaint department, and that's fine. It comes with a job, but there has to be something, like when Kevin said, perfect example, is there something that you can give to Dacono? And so that's in a nice way, I'm saying the same thing, or even in a mean way, the senior citizens of Dacono deserve, especially that whatever this attempt, I'm willing to raise my taxes to have a school built in Dacono, which we did. My kid's 34 years old and lives in Alaska, didn't benefit from that. I don't go to your rec center because I'm just not that guy. I live in a community that has a swimming pool and we have walking trails, so I exercise and so on and so forth. So I just don't use it. But those seniors, you know, having a handicapped mother, her being disabled and not being able to drive around, having to get her to the senior center, having to facilitate those logistics, and then seeing other people like that, I could spend the whole meeting tonight telling you how I feel about those seniors, but those are the people, and they're your voter. Quite honestly, they're your voter. They're the ones that are going to say yay or nay. Hardcore, and especially in Dacono, they are your voter. And so that's my rant with that. It's my passion. Like I said, I love the second rec district. I love that concept. You know, I don't see anything other than, it's kind of the old adage, what have you done for me lately? Like the song, the seniors, when I talk to them, and Dean, if you stop by there, you're going to get a big bum rush with those seniors going, hey man, where's our gimme, gimme, gimme. And that's fair, because you know that comes with the job. So I'll leave it alone at that. But that is truly my passion, is those seniors, like Kevin said, can we give them something? I feel they deserve something. And I'll stop there. Sorry to beat you guys up, but Cody's had too many breakfasts with me, so he's used to the rant. So he'll fill you in later.
And I love your rants. You know for a fact that my parents built from the ground up a nursing home, 65 bed skilled facility, yeah, in Oklahoma, and also 5 assisted livings throughout, yeah, all of Northeast Oklahoma. So yep, seniors are my passion as well. I helped growing up from 15 to 18, help my own grandfather do a community senior center in Berry Hill, Oklahoma, which is right outside Tulsa. Yep. So no, even our own senior centers, you know, I wish I had a kitchen. I wish I had this. You know, I'm used to senior centers where they're more almost like / event halls, you know, minus the alcohol, of course. But that's what I'm used to, and that's what our long-range goal is. Dean and I have had many conversations about this. This idea, this concept that was presented, is the best viable option for the short range to get the long-range goal. I want stuff in Dacono too. I got 5 kids. You know that.
Yep.
So no, I echo it, but this is the best we have for right now to reach those long range goals for all 3 communities.
And I thank you for that. I don't necessarily even need one in Dacono. My thoughts are is that I'd be willing to give you $11 a month if you gave the seniors their own space in Frederick, or if you gave the seniors a bigger room with a permanent kitchen so they can have meals 5 days a week. And so that's a concept that, like I said, it's more, what am I getting for my money? I'd be willing to give you $15 a month. And I'm not a tax guy. I'm the only mayor in the whole Frederick, Firestone, Dacono, Fort Lupton, Erie that's not asked for taxes in 6 years. So as far as raising that. So I'm not a big tax guy. I don't believe in that. I think that we should tighten our belts when things get tough and cut coupons like everybody else. But I'm willing to pay money to benefit those folks, just like I was willing to pay that mill levy for a new school here in Dacono, which we have. So that's got to be that has to be your passion. And I know you feel that way, Cody, and I know you do, Dean and Bill. I just got to throw that on your lap and I'll stop ranting.
Well, Joe, I always thank you for the talks. Always, always.
We'll catch up with breakfast, Cody, and I'm sure I'll wear you out sooner or later. And if you feel, adventurous enough to bring Dean in on the bludgeoning, you're welcome to do that. So
we can do that always.
I'm there.
I just scheduled a breakfast with Adam not too long ago.
Well, I'll load his lip up that we have on you while he's there.
But again, thank you, City Council. Thank you for your time.
Thank you guys. Thanks for having us tonight.
Yeah, we appreciate it.
You guys don't have to stay for the rest of it. Enjoy your night, and you can dump that screen and we'll go back to our meeting. And you guys have a good night. Thanks for listening. And we'll get back to the business at hand. So Next on the agenda this evening is comments on items that are not on the schedule on the agenda. If someone has a item that they would like to see, I think everyone's off now, aren't they, Age? Everybody just jumped off, so no one's here from the outside of the public. So seeing none, we'll move to the consent.
Yeah, I don't see anybody that's not a participant right now.
I appreciate your time. Let's move to the consent agenda. As council knows, these are regular items decided with one motion, one vote, no discussion, routine business like paying bills and buying copy machines. So if council sees something that needs to be taken off after I read it, please do so. We'll drop it down at the bottom and we'll move on forward. As presented, it is the meeting of June 14th, regular council meeting minute for 2021. Accounts payable dated today in the amount of $297,792.15. Acknowledgement of rate May, 2021 financial statements and corresponding manual journal entries. Council, in your lap.
I move to approve consent agenda as read.
I'll second.
Motion by Adam, second by Jackie. Can we receive a vote, please?
Danny Long?
Yes.
Kevin Plain?
Yes.
Adam Moorhead?
Yes.
Jackie Thomas?
Yes.
John Wargo?
Yes.
Catherine Whitman?
Yes.
And that motion passes with all saying yes. All right, so first item of business is a public hearing. It is a first reading ordinance for amendments in city zoning. Purpose of the public hearing is to receive evidence regarding an ordinance provided public forum for all interested parties and persons that wish to comment on the ordinance. Please do so at the time that I stayed out. If you are making a comment, we will give you 4 minutes and we will have you sworn in before you do so. I think it's star 9 to raise your hand. I still don't see somebody from the public, so I'm going to skim through. After we receive public comments, we'll allow staff to answer or rebut any questions or comments to be made. Council members may ask questions to people testifying and of staff. At the conclusion of testimony, I will close the meeting and we'll turn it back into council for action or movement. Does anyone have objections to this procedure that I've described? And does any public or council member have any disclosures about the public hearing involvement, anything, so on and so forth? So we will open the public hearing for ordinance 908, amending charter 16 of the Dacono Municipal Code to prohibit self-storage facilities and truck stop zone in all zone districts within the city of Dacono on first reading, and turn it over to our community development director, Jennifer Krieger.
Thank you, Mayor. This public hearing is for your consideration of ordinance 908, which would amend chapter 16, which is the city's zoning code, and prohibit self-storage and truck stops in all zone districts within the city. I'll start first with the self-storage. And in developing this recommendation, you may recall that last summer on July 13th, the City Council did pass a moratorium on new self-storage facilities in the city of Dacono. The council then held a study session on July 19th, 2021 to discuss policy direction for staff. We spent some time as council and staff later this spring talking about long-term growth and development along the I-25 corridor. Specifically, the council adopted resolution 2115 that really highlighted key elements of the city's economic development policies. And then also in March of 2021, the council did extend the moratorium. Actually, that was a different one for motor fueling stations to also address development along the I-25 corridor. We have, been dealing with this issue for almost a year now, doing research on the issue, and of course, getting feedback from the council on self-storage, and I should also mention then the truck stops. With this ordinance, staff is recommending that self-storage be prohibited in all zone districts. At one point in our discussion, we did look at providing perhaps a ratio of self-storage square footage to population. If you look at your ordinance in the recitals, It does reference that currently the city has more than 250,000 square feet of indoor self-storage and more than 32 acres of outdoor storage. And for a population of less than 6,000, the city of Dacono is overbuilt as it relates to this type of land use. We know from our discussions that this type of use really does not advance the goals of the comprehensive plan, nor the city's resolution 21-15 highlighting our economic development policies. So there's low employment there. These types of uses do not contribute to revenue generation for the city. Big footprints, low investment. So there's not much about the use that really benefits the city of Dacono long term. Additionally, when we did look at providing a suggested ratio of once the city's population reaches this number, then you know you could consider accepting additional applications. Like I said, with more than 250,000 square feet, it was going to be a very, very long time. And we just felt from an administrative perspective and policy that our recommendation would be to prohibit the use at this time and at a future date. And if a future council wanted to reconsider self-storage, they certainly would have the option. So that is our recommendation on self-storage. Additionally, with truck stops, as I mentioned, that in March of this year, the council did impose a temporary moratorium on motor fuel filling stations and truck stops. One of the it's sort of a mixed blessing at time of being along the I-25 corridor is that there is a lot of traffic and there can be a lot of visibility. And there has been increasing interest in some of these long or large truck stops locating close to the Summit Boulevard interchange. And so staff did do additional research since March regarding truck stops. And, there are all kinds of impacts from this type of use and secondary impacts, everything from the visual impact. We know that County Road 8 is a primary corridor leading into this community and serves development along I-25, and Summit Boulevard is really the front door and a first impression. And we believe that the use is inconsistent with the goals and policies of the comprehensive plan. The secondary impacts, including environmental impacts from idling trucks, crime, human trafficking, prostitution that frequently come along with this type of use are really inconsistent with the long-term goals of the city of Dacono. And therefore, we do recommend that the use be prohibited in the city's zoning code. With that, are there any additional questions that I might be able to answer?
Unmute. Questions, Council?
Ms. Kathy, I have a question. Okay, so we're putting the truck stops in here. And when you were talking about motor vehicle fueling stations. And then also the truck stops. So I know the truck stops are still motor, they're just filling the fueling stations. But a fueling station could also be, like 7-Eleven or you pump it, something like that. So I guess I'm looking for clarification. Is it truck stops or is it just motor fueling, or is that all encompassing every type of motor fueling station?
Sure, thank you. And that's a good point. I should clarify. The initial moratorium included all of those. However, this ordinance does specifically define a motor fuel filling station and a truck stop. And this ordinance would prohibit only truck stops, not motor fuel filling stations.
Thank you.
Other questions, council, comments? I think you also have to look at CAT that they, sometimes you'll have to look at some of the wording. They'll change the wording and call it a diesel fuel station or diesel fuel island. And then you can get away with that because it's politically correct. So it's not really a truck stop. It's considered a diesel fuel station, which fits an 80,000 pound truck there. So if you just call it a truck stop, then it just kind of covers all that semantics that people play with their word tracking. So if I'm reading it right, it may not be. Public comments to be made on this issue? Seeing none. Oh, go ahead, Danny, I'm sorry.
Yes, has anybody reached out to U-Haul and asked them if they're willing to make it a two-story building instead of a four?
I don't think that's
Councilman Long. I was gonna say, Councilman Long, this ordinance is separate and distinct from any previous application. You know, the council denied that application, I believe, last September. However, imposed the moratorium in July of last year. So, you know, from a staff perspective, we've just been looking only at the policy considerations, the Dacono Ford comprehensive plan, the economic development policy of the city, and the staff recommendation is not based on any kind of previous land use application.
I get that, you know, and I didn't even think about that, you know, when I opened my mouth. Thank you for listening.
It's the summer heat, buddy. We're all punchy. I don't see anybody from the public comments, so I'm just going to, unless the attorney stops me, I'm going to go ahead and close the public hearing and turn it back over to council for discussion or action.
Hey, Mayor, you may want to ask if there are any council members who have questions. Make sure that there aren't any more.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Are there any more questions, council? I don't see any heads flying around.
I guess I do have one, Joe. And that question would be, I think Jennifer lightly touched on that a council in the future could revisit this. So I'm thinking, and I guess I never want to assume, but we don't have a date stamped on this, or it's just a moratorium for now. It could be until next year. It could be 20 years from now. There's not a date stipulated. Is that correct?
No, Councilmember Thomas. This would be permanently adopting a prohibition on the use. What I was just suggesting was that in the future, if a future city council or even this council desires that, you know, darn it, we need more self-storage in this community, you certainly could look at amending the zoning code and creating, allowing it to be a special use or permitted use or something at some time in the future. But, you know, just like the moratorium says, we have a proliferation of this use. We are overbuilt. The residents' needs are currently addressed by the amount of square footage that is available in the city, and staff just recommends that the use be prohibited. The moratorium would go away per the once the ordinance took effect per the city charter.
Thanks, Jennifer.
Jennifer, can I ask another question?
Yeah.
Is there a reason why both of these were put in the same ordinance and not broken out separately?
Yes, because the section of the municipal code that they go into lists prohibited uses in the city. And so to me, it made sense to put them on a combined ordinance, since they do go in the same section, and since staff recommendation is prohibiting both uses, it just made sense. They both go in under section 16-10, prohibited uses.
Okay, thank you.
Other questions, council? All right, now I will close that part of the public hearing and go ahead and put it back in the council's lap.
I will move to approve Ordinance 908, amending Chapter 16 of the Dacono Municipal Code to prohibit self-storage facilities and truck stops in all zone districts within the city on first reading.
I second it.
Motion by Kevin Plaine, second by Danny Longford. Receive a vote, please.
Kevin Plaine?
Yes.
Adam Moorhead?
Yes.
Jackie Thomas?
Yes.
John Wargo?
Yes.
Catherine Whitman?
No.
Danny Long?
Yes.
That motion passed with everyone as a yes and Kathy Whitman as a no, passing by 5-6, if I'm correct. And we'll move on to consideration for Ordinance 909, amending Chapter 2 of the Dacono Municipal Code regarding write-in candidates and the cancellation of elections on first reading. Turn that to our city clerk, Valerie Taylor.
Good evening, Mayor and Council. This is Valerie Taylor, city clerk. The state statutes regarding the deadline for write-in candidates and canceling a municipal election have been amended. Ordinance 909 will amend Section 2-260 of the Dacono Municipal Code to coincide with state law. The changes include increasing the deadline for write-in candidates from 20 days to 64 days before the election, and provisions for canceling an election if the only matter before the voters is to fill a vacant seats and there are no more candidates than open seats. This is related to that 64 days before the election also. There has been one change to the ordinance that was in your packet, and there are two words that are to be stricken, and I found out right before the meeting that this was, and Kathleen will explain it, but the prior to 64 days in paragraph A will be removed, stricken on the next version that you see for second reading. And Kathleen, I'll let you explain that, why that is being stricken from there.
Sure. Thanks, Val. So there's a bit of an inconsistency between the municipal election code, which would apply if the city were to hold its own standalone election, and the uniform election code, which applies when the city coordinates its election. So the municipal election code has that prior to in the write-in candidate affidavit deadline, and the uniform election code does not. Since the city almost always, I don't want to say always, because you do have the authority to hold your own election at any point should you choose, but you know, typically the city coordinates with Weld County, so the appropriate change to make to the code is without the prior to, so that we align with the uniform election code, which is required when you coordinate with the county.
Cool. All right. Questions for the administration council? Pretty fair, pretty simple. Thank you.
I guess I do have a question.
Sure.
Just curious. How or why did this come up in our discussions or come up for an amendment?
I'll take that one, Val. It was when we were reviewing the election calendar for this year. You know, each year the General Assembly makes little tweaks to the election laws. And this was one that had recently been made, and we hadn't yet updated your code to reflect what's currently in the state statute. So we are a little bit behind in doing this, but that's how we found it, was checking dates for your election calendar for your upcoming election.
Okay, thank you.
Other questions, council, for the administration? All right, seeing none, we'll go back to council for action.
I'll make the motion to approve Ordinance 909, amending Chapter 2 of the Dacono Municipal Code regarding write-in candidates and the cancellation of elections on first reading.
I'll second that.
Motion by Whitman, second by Thomas. Can we receive a vote, please?
Adam Moorhead?
Yes.
Jackie Thomas?
Yes.
John Wargo?
Yes.
Catherine Whitman?
Yes.
Danny Long?
Yes.
Kevin Plaine?
Yes.
That motion passed with all saying yes. I guess I should have said this before, but just as a guessing man reading into that too, Jackie, it also saves money if you have somebody that's running unopposed. So we have had elections in the past where candidates have ran unopposed, where there's only like two seats and two people running, or three seats and three people running. So why bother is what I'm thinking. And that's just me thinking out loud. I didn't have anything to do with it. But when I read through that ordinance, I kind of thought of that process also, because we have, in the years I've been there, I've seen candidates just run. I was like, why spend the money if they're running unopposed? They've already got the signatures. They're automatically elected. So, and that happens nationally too. So I'll leave that rant alone. All right, folks, let's get down to brass tacks here in the long and ugly. Okay, so I think council's got some scripts on here, but what we're going into next is item C, which is an executive session for discussion of a personnel matter under the Colorado Revised Statute 24-6-4024F, and not involving any specific employees who have requested discussion of a matter in open session, any member of this body, or an elected official. The appointment of any person to fill an office of this body or an elected official, or personnel policies that do not require discussion of matters personal to particular employees, and for the purpose of receiving legal advice on specific legal questions under Colorado Revised Statute 24-6-4024B, specifically concerning discussion of city employee. And I believe we would have a motion for that. I guess just a so move would work on that, Kathleen?
Yes, that's right.
All right, I'll move to go into executive session as read.
I'll second that motion.
All right, that motion passes, and then we're going into that. Does everyone need a bathroom break or something, or water break, or scotch, or vodka? Or?
Mayor, you need a roll call vote.
Oh, yeah. Sorry about that, Kathleen. I got ahead of myself to get them all punchy. I've been frozen in time here. Motions on the table by Kevin, was it, and Jackie? Thank you. Can we receive a vote, please?
Jackie Thomas?
Yes.
John Wargo?
Yes.
Catherine Whitman?
Yes.
Danny Long?
Yes.
Kevin Plain?
Yes.
Adam Moorhead?
Yes.
All right, that motion passes, and we are now heading into executive session. Usually we're heading downstairs, so but not for long. Does anyone need a break right quick, or you want to just pop into this?
It'd be nice if we took a 5-minute.
Let's rock it out really quick, and then we'll meet you downstairs, folks.
Thank you.
Okay, I will need to put Val and Jordan in a breakout room if they choose to hang on until we go through the executive session.
Do we want them? Well, do we need Val for?
I write down all the times that we go in and out of everything, so I'll be happy to continue to do that.
No worries. Whatever your call on that, if they're staying or not. So yeah, if you want to throw them in the dungeon.
I'd be happy to leave, but if you want to do staff reports before I leave so I can get that in the minutes, that would be good.
I'm really ahead of myself. You're absolutely right. Usually we do staff reports, and my brain is not here today. I had a full morning, so I apologize for not being here, for being a little funky. So let's do staff reports now, and then we'll just cut them all loose. I apologize.
Kathleen, is that okay if we do that since the motion's been made to go to executive session?
Yes, I mean, you're all still on the record in the open meeting, so.
You know, and what we will do in the future is just move that on the agenda so that staff reports are ahead of going into an executive session.
I get it. Go ahead. Pick on the old guy that forgot everything. I get it, AJ. Well, you saw me. I was all scarred up and had bandages around my arm like a moron. So.
No, you were. You're all patched up, and hopefully you're better.
Yeah, we'll see. Right. So, all right, let's get staff reports. We're going to you first, Age.
Sure. Hopefully, I can get in on that little break here right after this.
You want to give it to Val first and come back?
So no. I'll just go ahead and nothing more to add since my weekend update I sent out. Just kind of a reminder on events. City offices are closed on July 5th. We've got our summer splash event on July 6th. That's a Tuesday up at the splash pad. That's from 1 to 3 where we, you know, give out some things. I think we have Kona ice there to give away treats for everybody. Those are all complimentary. Give away some swag. So if any council members can join us, that'd be great. Hopefully the weather works out. July 7th, there is not a URAD meeting. That's been canceled, as the August meeting has been canceled as well. Then we go to July 10th. That's our next music and movie where we have Face Vocal Band. And the movie is Ghostbusters. We're very confident this year that having Face on our roster will not bring in the bad weather. It has at our music festival every year. So this is going to be the year where they get through their whole performance, and it's just amazing. So that's really all I have right now.
Okay, thank you, AJ. Congratulations on your re-election to Colorado Municipal League Executive Board number one. We do thank you for getting on there. I don't know if everyone knows about that board. I served on that board. I love having someone from Dacono on that because it really keeps our presence in the whole state and keeps our ear to the ground on what's going on with the state. So it really does help us. I feel it does, and I'm super happy that you're serving. I love the mixture of managers and electeds because it also gives a good blend on perspective of where management's coming from and then also elected. So congratulations on that. I didn't mean to throw you up on the pedestal, but thanks, man. I appreciate you doing that.
But thank you for your support. I appreciate it, and council backing me to do that. It is truly an honor to be reelected to that board. So thank you.
Other staff reports, Val?
I just want to let you know that speaking of the election calendar, August 3rd will be the first day that petitions can be picked up from me. We're going to have to figure out how to do that. I'll probably be at the police department with that because I think that's the time when we can't be in our building. So I'll get the specifics out. I just want to, I'll keep mentioning this at each meeting so that people get it, get their reminders in to come pick up petitions, and we'll get it out on our social media that where the pickup location will be. And that's all I have.
You might be standing out on the corner like a, you know, with like a, just with like a sign says petitions here, right? The way I just got the last tour of that place, and the dust is flying everywhere in City Hall right now. So
it is.
You said August the 3rd for petitions. What do we have available? There's an election this year, and there's some seats up. What seats are available? What seats are up? Who's up?
We have two council members and the mayor seat are up for election this year.
So the heat is on. Okay. And that's August the 3rd, you said?
Yes.
Okay. Beautiful. Anything else? Hang on, Daniel. I'll grab you in a second.
That is it.
Cool. Go ahead, Danny.
My son got a park no seatbelt ticket. Where can I go pay that at? He gave me the money.
I'll take the money, bro.
Police station.
Yes, you can play that. You can pay that at the police station or City Hall if you have the ticket with you. Either one.
Either one.
Okay. Yeah.
All right. I'll see you on Friday.
Other staff reports, Jordan, you have anything for us, or are you just going to get out of here for the night?
I do not. Thanks for the offer, but I don't.
No worries. How about council? You guys have anything to tell us what's going on your side of the fence with the deal?
I only had one question for AJ. Are they going to get the swag like the City of Dacono beach balls that are in the poster picture?
He's on mute.
I'm not sure what the swag is, Kathy.
Yeah, those beach balls are pretty cool. And then some of the kids that said, oh, do we get one of those? And I said, I don't know. I'd have to ask. So, okay. Thanks, AJ.
Yeah, I went digging for swag because a kid wrote me a letter from Alabama, and I was going to try to send him some swag. And the only thing I had in my collection was I had a coffee cup, you know, one of those coffee cups is all I had. So I mailed him a coffee cup and mailed him a letter back. Kid was from Salem, Alabama, wrote a letter, an 8-year-old kid wrote a letter about three little things, just saying that he was learning about the 50 states and different cities, and picked Dacono, Colorado, and asked if there was anything he can tell me about the history. So I sent him a handwritten letter, which I have terrible handwriting, but I figured I better write it back in hand. So I wrote him a handwritten letter on letterhead and gave him a little history lesson and said, you know, we've tried to refer him to the website and send him that. So, because I was digging for swag for anything, and I think we're out. But that's my rant. What else, Council? Anything else? Nothing. So, all right. Let's go for a break, and we'll be back here in about 4 or 5 minutes. Right. The time is now 8:14 p.m. and the executive session has concluded. The participants in the executive session was Councilmember Jackie Thomas, Councilmember Catherine Whitman, Councilmember Kevin Plain, Councilmember John Borgo, Mayor Pro Tem Adam Moorhead, myself, Joe Baker, presiding officer, Mayor, Councilmember Danny Long, the attorney Kathleen Kelly, City Manager AJ Newkirk. For the record, if any person who participated in the executive session believes that any substantial discussion of any matters not included in the motion to go into executive session occurred during the executive session, or that any improper action occurred during the executive session in violation of the open meeting laws, I would ask that you state your concerns for the record now. Thank you, Council. Seeing none, we'll move on to the next agenda, which is motion for adjournment.
So moved.
Second.
Third.
Third. Yeah, motion by Kathy, second by Kevin. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
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 All right, no opposed. Council, thank you, staff. Thank you, Kathleen. Thank you, AJ, for hanging in there. Everybody else, so try to have a good night.
Good night.
Good night, everybody.
Good night.